Hello all, so welcome again. So today what we will discuss is how you can become an environmental health professional. My name is Uri Chaudhary, and we'll go deeper into the various skill set of an environmental health professional, the certifications that are available for environmental health professionals, as well as the courses that you may be taking when you are in a university trying to get a degree in environmental health. Some of the skill set that are needed in environmental health are shown in this diagram, and they're pretty common across many of the disciplines in the sciences. So let's quickly go over. So you definitely need very significant analytical and problem-solving skills, as well as deductive and inductive reasoning. Critical thinking and scientific reasoning are also very important, and strong scientific foundation is very critical. Interest in laboratory analysis, knowledge of environmental rules and regulations definitely are critical for your success in this field. And finally, written and verbal communication wrap up the skill set that employers value. So what are the steps in a career for a career in environmental health? First of all, earn a bachelor's degree in public health with emphasis in environmental health, or a degree in environmental health by itself, or in the general sciences such as biology, chemistry, and microbiology. While doing a BS, make sure you are able to gain work experience by doing internships, research in environmental health, as well as gain additional work experience after graduation. Also consider a master's degree such as an MS or MPH in the field of environmental health. Earn certification such as REHS-RS, which stands for Registered Environmental Health Specialist, as well as OSHA's Compliance Assistance Specialist Certification and National Radon Safety Board's Radon Certification. If you are considering academic jobs in environmental health, a PhD typically is a must. The courses that you may be taking when you are enrolled in a degree in environmental health range from basic science and math courses, core public health courses, as well as courses in the field of environmental health, chosen from a variety of courses shown in here. The sciences, as you can see in here, are biology, chemistry, physics, as well as some basic math, college level math courses. Core public health courses such as Introduction to Environmental Health, Epidemiology, Biostatistics, and Public Administrations are also very important to take and actually required for a degree in environmental health. And then you can choose a variety of courses listed in here, depending on what is available at your universities and your specific interest. Certification-wise, there are quite a few options out there. NEHA, which stands for National Environmental Health Association, offers the Registered Environmental Health Specialist or Registered Sanitarian, which is REHS-RS certification. It is the gold standard in environmental health. Obtaining professional credentials assures that an individual has obtained and can demonstrate core competencies that are relevant to providing communities with high quality environmental health services. Also, the process of obtaining certification ensures that the individual is current with contemporary standards within the profession and is utilizing best practice models consistent with current research and science. Employer-wise, local health departments at the city, county, and state level agencies, that's where it probably would be, you'll find employment. And the monitoring that will happen as an environmental health professionals will be monitoring local restaurants, swimming pools, homes for lead or radon, as well as looking for hazardous waste and working in hazardous waste sites and responding to community complaints and concerns. You can also work at different industries such as Procter & Gamble, Starbucks, Darden restaurants, for example. They hire REHS-RS certified individuals. You may also find employment in academia, in the armed forces, as well as at the federal level, such as the CDC, EPA, FDA, and USDA. In California, you can also obtain the REHS certification, which is offered by by the environmental management branch. So the REHS program is required by California Health and Safety Code, and it is administered by the environmental management branch. The REHS program ensures that individuals who are REHS have met prescribed education, training, and experience requirements, and have passed a comprehensive examination reflective of the demands encountered within the environmental health professionals. CEHA stands for California Environmental Health Association. It's a state level association, and it is committed to providing for the professional growth and development of the environmental health professional. It is primarily an organization of volunteers dedicated to environmental health profession, which includes the protection of public health and the environment. I hope that by going over the slides, you've been able to get a glimpse of the skill set that is required for a degree in environmental health, for a career in environmental health, the type of courses that you would be exposed to in a university, and the various certification that in some cases required, in other cases that just makes you more marketable. So thank you again for listening, and do not forget to subscribe.